Hello friends, now we are going to talk about common ion effect. So as the name says, common ion is nothing but basically the presence of the two ions that are basically present in the same solution. For example, if I'm talking about a solution, suppose it consists of that is weak electrolyte as well as strong electrolyte, so we'll contain that is the same ions, and that same ions that are being present in the solution, they are known as common ion. So what is common ion effect? Let us talk about it. So for this now, we are going to study about what is common ion effect. So before understanding, an ion common to the two electrolyte is called as common ion. For example, if I am taking a strong electrolyte like that of that is CH3CONa, that is sodium acetate. And again, if I am taking the electrolyte that is CH3COOH, the both are electrolyte. But the thing is, one is a strong electrolyte and one is a weak electrolyte. So that's the reason that this one will dissociate completely so as to form an acetate ion, along with that of the sodium ion. While this one will not dissociate completely and it will form an acetate ion that we could see over here, along with that of the H plus. So the both the electrolytes are being present, suppose if in the same solution, and so that is the, because basically we are talking about a buffer solution. So in this case, basically the two ions are basically common. So therefore, this is the common ion that we have got over in that solution. So what is this responsible for? So what is the function of this thing? And that is basically known as common ion effect. And what is that? So let us understand that is what is actually common ion effect. So before that, we should understand that that is suppression of the, that is degree of dissociation of a weak electrolyte, or we could say that is the solubility of a sparingly soluble salt by addition of a strong electrolyte having an ion in common with the weak electrolyte is called as common ion effect. So this is what I wanted to explain with the help of this example. So suppose if we have that is a weak electrolyte that is CH3COOH, or we could call it as acetic acid. So we know that it doesn't dissociate completely, and that's the reason that the degree of dissociation is very much less. But even the degree of dissociation can be reduced by addition of a strong electrolyte which consists of the common ion. So in this case, suppose if a acetic acid we have, and in that case suppose if we are adding a strong electrolyte which has a common ion with that. And that is basically if I am adding the electrolyte that is sodium acetate, which gives us the ion that is CH3COO minus, that is the acetate ion. So the degree of dissociation can be suppressed for the that is acetic acid. And that is the reason that the solubility of the acetic acid can also be suppressed or can also be reduced. So this kind of effect that we could observe is basically known as common ion effect, and that is what we have got to know, that is what we have understood in the buffer action also. And this is what I wanted to talk about, and that is because of the common ion effect. And because as you would see over here, because the concentration of the that is the CH3CO minus, it is going on increasing if we add a strong electrolyte. So obviously this will interact with the H plus that has been formed because of the dissociation, and obviously the acetic acid will be formed. And again, it won't dissociate completely because acetic acid is a weak acid. So whatever the H plus ion that has been produced or it has been dissociated, now it would be consumed by the strong electrolyte's ion, and that is in this case is the acetate ion. And that's the reason that again that the CH3COH will be formed. And if that forms, then how can we say that the particular that is acetic acid is being basically much more soluble in water, or it is much more soluble in a particular solvent. So that's the reason that the solubility it gets reduced. Or we could say that even though by separating or dissociating, even the degree of dissociation will be very much reduced because of the help of the ion that is which is common, and that is what it has been added. So therefore, this is basically known as common ion effect, and that is how we can prevent the dissociation of a particular compound. So this is how it works. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and there are many much more that is applications of common ion effect that we are going to take in the next lecture. So stay tuned for that, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.